Okay, next we're differentiating functions with more than one term. So as I said in the last part of the chapter, you simply just differentiate each part separately when they're separated by adding some tracks. So example 8, you've got 4x cubed plus 2x, and differentiate it to get dy dx, so times by the power reduced to the power by 1, any number x goes to that number. B, x cubed goes to 3x squared, x squared goes to 2x, x to the half goes to, so sides those the same, half x to the minus half. C, divide the x, times by the power, so it's a bit more difficult, we've got a third times a half is a sixth, reduced to the power by 1 is minus half, times by the power, reduced to the power by 1, which is 1, so just leave it alone. Okay, example 9. You've got to differentiate each of these, but first we need to manipulate them until they're in a format where I can differentiate like these were. So firstly, I need to realise this is 1 over 4x to the half. And what we need to do before we can differentiate is bring that to the top, bring it to the numerator. And to do that, all we simply do is make the power of x negative. Don't bring the 4 up, leave the 4 alone. It's a quarter x to the minus half. When it's in that form, you can differentiate it very easily. So f dash of x means it's been differentiated. So times by the power minus an eighth x to the minus 1/2 minus 3/2. This one, we don't differentiate these two separately and times them together. We first expand the bracket, so each term is separated only by add and subtract. So when you expand the bracket, you get 3x to the 4 plus x cubed. You can differentiate it easily. It's going to be times by the power reduced to the power by 1, times by the power reduced to the power by 1. Fractions. Now, what you need to remember when you're trying to differentiate fractions is you must split it up so you've got separate terms. So we differentiate each part of the numerator separately by the denominator, then tidy that up. When you divide, you subtract the powers, bring it this to the top, the power becomes negative. And now you can differentiate it quite easily. So times by the power, reduce the power by 1. Times by the power, be careful there because you've got minus 2 times minus 2 is plus 4. Reduce the power by 1. Okay, we're going now to exercise 12E.